Hey, my friend, Drew Canole. We are on the way to meet one of my good friends, and I wanted to bring you with me. You see, my friend Jim is a traditional Chinese medicine doctor, and he understands functional medicine, so he looks at the whole body as this awakened machine. And once we know how to turn it on, then it can literally heal from the inside out. What we're talking about today is thyroid health, and it's an epidemic that's plaguing the modern world as we know it. And if you're experiencing any thyroid condition, or you're thinking maybe you have some of the symptoms, I wanted to bring you with me and introduce you to my good buddy Jim, so that you and I could really get to the bottom of this. Because when I say we're in this together, you know I mean it. So let's go meet Jim. I'm with Jim Chaltis here in sunny San Diego. He's my acupuncturist, and he wanted to give some of his time to you today to help us understand this epidemic that's happening throughout the world, and that is thyroid health. So he's a traditional Chinese medicine practitioner, two kids, loves life in San Diego, getting out in nature. He's a true fit lifer. So he's here, he's gonna help us today. Thanks for coming on, my man.
Thanks for having me.
So one of the questions we ask everyone in the community is, why do you do what you do?
Well, I've had a fascination with human health my whole life, for sure. Mm-hmm. And as I've gotten into practicing, I have really seen a huge problem with general energy and kind of productivity and happiness in life, really. That's what I like to offer as best as I can, getting function back and giving people the ability to enjoy their lives.
And you've spent over 1,500 hours helping people in acupuncture specifically before you became...
It was about a 1,500-hour master's degree, which is approximately a four-year degree after college.
Somebody that's not familiar with acupuncture, what would you tell them? Like, what does it do in the human body?
It's not as scary as it sounds. acupuncture is one tool that we can use as acupuncturists to regulate body energy. We call it qi. But regardless of what you want to call it, or believe in it wholeheartedly or not, we are stimulating the body using this point system to help invigorate and energize the body.
Yeah, opening up meridians. And one of the meridians we're actually talking about today, I don't even know if it's a meridian, but the thyroid. Right?
It's not a meridian, but I can kind of make some correlations for sure.
So it's this gland. Well, tell us a little bit about the thyroid. What does it do?
Sure. The thyroid is, as you were pointing to your throat, it's located in our throat. The thyroid gland, think of it as your gas pedal. I mean, it is your metabolism. So some of the most common things I treat here are low thyroids. If you have a low thyroid, you're not pushing on the gas pedal very fast and everything slows down.
So how does that show up in your day? What do you experience if you have a low thyroid?
Suffering energy levels for sure. Depression, poor motivation, low libido, constipation.
Yeah, because before,
among other things,
before I came in here and started working with you, you had me fill out like this 6-page questionnaire, and a lot of the questions were relative to energy and libido and all that other stuff. So what you do is you look at it from an integrative approach and much more of a functional way to really understand the human body.
My practice, though I am an acupuncturist by medical license and I do Chinese medicine, I have also formed a specialty in functional blood chemistry. And that really allows us to address things like thyroid, because the ancient Chinese didn't know what the thyroid was. They might, getting back to your meridian question, it might be like a spleen or kidney meridian, which has to do with your daily energy and your longevity concepts.
Let's talk specifically about things that you would advise your clients to do outside of getting acupuncture. To increase the gas pedal, to give them more energy, to help them out throughout the day.
Balance your blood sugar, which means avoiding all the garbage. I mean, you know, really, we have to really work hard at it in this day and age. Odds are stacked against us, just waking up in the morning.
Okay, so balancing blood sugar would be things like cutting out sugar, dairy, wheat, gluten, things like that?
Sure, right? Yes, because things that have dairy and gluten in them tend to be very simple in general and will lead to an unstable blood sugar. And on top of it, if you are sensitive to those things, that will be inflammatory, that will cause stress in the system, that will slow the whole process down as well.
Obviously, sleep would be pretty important.
Yeah, all the basic stuff, you know, the blood sugar and sleep and proper hydration.
Yep.
You bet.
This is more of a woman problem as well that we're dealing with.
You tend to see low thyroids more in women, for sure.
And it can impact getting pregnant, you know, fertility issues.
It certainly can.
Different things like that.
It certainly can. And in fact, female hormones have been known to sort of slightly turn down the thyroid activity, which is interesting. So if any of your viewers here have ever been on, let's say, the birth control pill and then not noticed a weight gain or a difficulty losing weight, it's a direct result of this hormone impacting the thyroid system.
I think that's very common. Yeah, and it's then they wonder why they're not able to lose the weight and get the body that they want, and it all could be relative to thyroid.
Right.
So the warning signs of an underactive thyroid, can you tell us some of those? I've heard that, like, losing hair.
Yeah. We talked about some of the symptoms, like the low energy and low drive and all that stuff. But yeah, the outer third of the eyebrow, for some reason, that's a real common sign that you can just notice somebody on the street and kind of and recognize their low thyroid issue.
Yeah.
Hair loss in general, you know, just thinning of the hair in general.
So you said there's 23 things. We're not going to go through them all today, but what are some of the other ones to tell if somebody has a low thyroid?
Well, it would be mostly to sift through some of that, you'd need to do a really intricate blood workup.
Okay.
The end result is low thyroid hormone, low free T3. That's the end. That's what you feel. How many steps there are along the way is the question. And that takes a really comprehensive blood workup.
So somebody that wants to do this and maybe engage in having a functional practitioner like yourself look at the blood, what tests would you recommend?
I recommend the gold standard for thyroid is the thyroid stimulating hormone, TSH.
Yep.
That'll tell you a tremendous amount right off the bat. But we want T4,
yep.
T3 uptake, and then perhaps a free T4 and free T3. Okay. And for good measure, some thyroid antibodies. Thyroid antibodies are immune system proteins that are attacking the thyroid.
Cool.
The leading cause of low thyroid.
And they can order them through you?
They certainly can.
Okay, cool.
80% of the things I just mentioned are not getting screened on a typical doctor's visit.
Yeah, because I've never had the tested by a Western doc. I've always had T3 and T4, but none of the other ones that you're talking about. So I know in the juicing community, a lot of people are freaking out about goitrogenic foods. In regards to this,
yes.
What do you have to say about that?
Okay, for those of you who don't know what a goitrogen is, it's a compound that can enter into the thyroid system and block the uptake of iodine.
Okay.
Iodine is an essential nutrient for the thyroid process. So certain foods, let's just say cabbage, is a known goitrogen.
Mm-hmm. Now, kale.
All of those cruciferous type vegetables tend to have these compounds in them. Please don't stop eating those things. We need to eat those things. Yeah. So you mentioned the juicing community. That's the only time that somebody can really impact the system is if they are drinking literally gallons of cabbage juice. Yes.
I've been known to do that.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. And even temporarily, it's probably going to be just fine for you. So I consider goitrogens for most people to be very, very safe.
Cool.
Because the reality is we're not consuming the quantity that we would need to fully suppress a thyroid.
Yeah, people get so worked up over that.
It's a 1960s naturopathic model.
Okay.
That's sort of stuck.
So we've talked about goitrogens. Now that's more for hypothyroid, right? Mm-hmm. Slowing of the thyroid. What about hyper? Is there any foods that people need to be sensitive to?
There aren't too many specific foods that I know of that are known triggers, but I can always fall back on inflammatory foods like gluten and dairy. Those are some of the two most common. If you have a hyperthyroid condition, you have an autoimmune condition. And so those foods are just known to drive it. So if you're telling your immune system to
fight
and kill what it remembers, and if that's your thyroid, then you have Graves' disease. And
so leaky gut plays a big role in this, right? Having a gut inflammation where your white blood cells are actually sent to your gut area, and you're constantly fighting off your body thinks is an infection. So you don't have enough white blood cells when disease creeps in to fight it. You want to talk a little bit more about that?
A good chunk of the immune system, something like 75%, is located around the guts and intestines. It is the interface between sort of the outside and inside of our bodies.
Yeah.
So the more we are stimulating that with these foreign invaders, so to speak, the less energy we have for other things. But really what it's doing is creating inflammation systemically. If your guts are inflamed, your vessels are inflamed, your brain is inflamed.
Okay,
your
cool.
thyroid receptors are inflamed and they don't work. You know, every single part will be over time.
So we shot a video last week on gut health, and then the week before was inflammatory foods, things to avoid. So we went over 23 things. You guys can check that out as well. But hopefully this was helpful to you. And if you want to order the tests, I'm going to leave them below here. If you're in San Diego and you actually want to come in and meet the man, the myth, the legend, you can do that. I'm about to get a little acupuncture. If you guys have been following me for a while, I hurt my neck probably a month and a half, 2 months ago, and it's been flaring up off and on. So I think acupuncture has helped big time. You know, it's really freed up some of that chi, you would say.
Sure.
Some of that stored.
Stagnated chi.
Yep. So now that it's moving, it feels better. I can get back to the gym and do what I love doing. So cool. Thanks, my man.
Thanks a lot.
Easy enough. All right. So who won the juicer this week? We have Polly Love Gale. Polly, absolutely amazing. She has been making all kinds of healthy food for her son. And her son is absolutely transforming. She's loving the recipes. And because she's doing that for her family, we're going to send her out a brand new juicer. So Polly Love Gale, congratulations. You are the winner of the Covings juicer this week. All right, my friend. So I'm just leaving Jim, the acupuncturist, the guy that I introduced you guys to. And a wealth of information, right? So now we know that goitrogenic foods don't really make that much of an impact, as long as we're not drinking gallons of kale juice every single day or different goitrogenic foods, right? We also understand what it means to be hypothyroid versus hyper and how it is an autoimmune condition a lot of times. You know, it's disguised as this autoimmune condition. And you know, I really appreciated the fact that Jim actually talked about healing the gut as well, and we were able to bring that forward because 70 to 80% of your immune system lies in your gut. So if we can start to fix that with the principles that I shared with you in the Gut Healing Saturday strategy, overall, your thyroid will have much more of an opportunity. So I believe that gas pedal analogy is perfect. And I want you to feel like you have energy, consistent energy all day long so that you can pursue what you want to pursue and you can live out your passion, whatever dream, desire you have in this life. That's what this is about. So if I can interview experts and different people that can impart their knowledge on you as well as me and help us, that's what the very definition of we're in this together means. So I want to help you with that and anything that I can do. If you guys have any questions whatsoever in regards to different experts, if it's a naturopathic doctor and you have a question for them or acupuncturist, let me use my network of people to help you. And I'm totally able to do that. And I want to do that because I want you thriving. I don't want you just getting by. I think getting by is a waste of time. I want you to feel optimum. I want you to feel like a superhuman, right? So those people that are close to you, your friends, your family, the people that care about you and that you love, look at you and you're the demonstration. You inspire them to be a healthier person. And that's what I want. So if you want that as well, give this video a big thumbs up. I know I'm driving. I am safe though. I'm not looking at the camera that much. So if you're out there thinking he should not be driving and filming this, I'm being completely safe, I promise. And I appreciate bringing you on this journey, this ride of what we call life. Boy, is it fun. When we feel great and we're able to give back and really help people, it's a cool thing. So I'm Drew Cannoli. As always, remember, we're in this together, and I'll see you next week. Oh.